Thank you for attending tonight's local school board meeting, January 25th. Can we have a roll call, please, Mr. Massler?
Mrs. Megatow?
Yes.
Mrs. Farrow?
Here.
Mr. Jewell?
Here.
Mrs. Miller?
Here.
Mrs. Milligan?
Here.
Thank you. Can we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
Our Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you. At this time, we will take any visitors' comments. We don't look like we have any this evening, so we'll move on to the Treasurer's Report.
I do have one non-action item, an email that I got earlier today about the state and the state foundation for payments, only because I got good news today. I'd like to share the state budget that is going to be in place, at least at this point. They gave us notification today that the reduction that we took at the end of last year, so we lost the money at the end of last year for our state foundation, and then that stayed in place again to lose that same amount of money this year, that $230,000. We're going to get $130,000 back. So, good news is that we're going to get a little bit more money than we anticipated. So, thank the legislatures for that one. Not often do we, you know, get excited and thank legislature about stuff, but in this case, positive cash flow for us or what we thought we were going to be getting. So I just wanted to share that good news. With that, then I'll do the action items on the approval for our last two board meetings, which was the regular meeting on December 21st and the organizational meeting on January the 4th.
Mrs. Milligan first. Mrs. Miller second.
Now call the roll.
Call the roll, please.
Mrs. Milligan?
Yes.
Mrs. Miller?
Yes.
Mrs. McIntosh?
Yes.
Mrs. Winkler?
Yes.
And Mr. Jewell?
Yes.
And secondly, is the financial report, which is part of your packet. Moving right along through the year, this would be year end, not fiscal year end, but calendar year end closed December 31st. So, pretty much halfway through the fiscal year for us. Again, other than COVID related expenses, the things over no surprises, except for the good news that I expressed to you earlier, it does appear that we will get another. COVID relief payment. Tentatively, those numbers are out and finalized, so I don't want to try to tell you exactly what it is going in. It could be a very good number for us, but I don't want to necessarily say those numbers yet until I'm sure what those numbers are going to be. But all indications are it's going to be bigger than it was last time, so it could be up to three times as big as what we had the last time. So, other than that, if you have any questions about financial report, if not, I need a motion for approval.
We have one question on COVID money. I read a little bit about it today. Are there different restrictions? Are they changing some of the restrictions or the interest of the money a little bit in this round?
And what I read today, that they are going to be a little bit more restrictive than the last time. And they said the guidelines are coming. So I've not had an opportunity to read the guidelines yet, but it did say that it was going to be a little bit more restrictive than next time. What that means, I don't know. But I certainly will do my best to make it money that's the plans for me to go on that saves us money in the general fund and not make this run.
Perfect. So. Can I get a motion, please? First by Mrs. Lightheart, second by Mr. Jewell. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Lightheart?
Yes.
Mr. Jewell?
Yes.
Mrs. Miller?
Yes.
Mrs. Milligan?
Yes.
McIntosh.
Yes.
And lastly, I have a couple of appropriation modifications. Federal grant dollars, halfway through the year, they usually true up what they have going on. So our Title VI, which is a special ed, and our Title IV, just got a little bit of a change in the appropriation, which I need to have approval.
Can I get a motion, please? First by Mr. Jewell.
Second.
Second by Mrs. Milligan. Can I have a roll call, please?
Mr. Jewell?
Yes.
Mr. Milligan?
Yes.
Mrs. Blayhart?
Yes.
Mrs. McIntosh?
Yes.
Mr. Miller? Yes. Mrs. Miller?
Yes.
Sorry.
This is a topic, you know.
And I'm sure I'm probably going to do that and set others as we go along. So it's probably not the last apology that I issued. So, with that mistake, that's my report. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Bassler. Dr. Bell, we'll turn it over to you for your superintendent's report.
Thank you. A few non-action items. First is going to update the some ways to be addressed, but as things progress, we also find things that also need to be addressed. So we're hopefully going from big ticket items to small ticket items, but every day brings something new to us, whether it be a chip here, a lot there, a sound alarm there. So we work on things that we saw week by night that we play around with them. And we should be up in the system of the weather cooperates with the audience. We did have a little setback with our faxes and phones. As spectrum was supposed to be today, it will be next week. We can send the faxes out of two of our three machines where we can accept on any of those machines. So hopefully we don't forget that taken care of, as well as our phone system straightened out. Like I said, every day, especially with the weather, changing weather, we're finding different things that are happening. There's some condensation as we get some expanding and contractions going up by ourselves. We just have to say a few things like that. The people were pretty responsive to requests to look at things and try and take care of it as quickly as they can. Give a shout out to our staff at PSP, so that they've getting everything taken care of. Some more than others, but they're all pretty patient with the time that they've taken care of. So we'll continue to keep putting out things. Next item is the calendar for our next school year, the 2022 school year. For your review, this attachment D was able to work with the same way in Tim Harrison classes about a few different calendars. The same was updated with a couple different options. We tried to see what we could do about sorting the year as far as the number of days we had to work with. There's a lot of stuff there. We have to work some days. We made sure that that's been in. So the new calendar behind us is starting a little bit later, obviously in August, and then it will be done before Memorial Day. This does give us a full week of Thanksgiving, 2 full weeks of Christmas, and one full week in the spring as well, along with our professional development days and our parent teacher conference coming days. Just send a vote out. I've got that results back. It's about 2-1 vote, just like the calendar we did have. And then to go along with that, we would like to go into discussion at some point after we get through one of the things we can get together and start maybe looking at multi-year contracts, but we don't have to do this every year. We're going to be doing it. Maybe we're going to go along with it for a good set of plans to work with on a multi-year calendar at some point. Any questions about the calendar plan? There was one question on the, I think it was Easter, which was really because the green was marked as holidays. They said, could you make it like Monday instead of Sunday? So now the template that we used had all the holidays in green already. And then when we used green to show the holidays, it didn't show up as well. And you'll see that the 25th and the 1st are both holidays and those are holidays. I don't want to lose any question, but there was just a little clarification on that. The last item is board appreciation. We did mention this at the last board meeting at the organization meeting simply because January is board appreciation month by the Ohio School Boards Association. And since you have your board meeting so late in the month, it gives you a whole, this whole week to celebrate it. So we did want to bring that up at the last board meeting organization meeting so you can revel in all that congratulations the whole month long. So we certainly really appreciate all that you do, not just this month, but year round. So at this time, what I'd like to do is, maybe we could have a conference in the fall and do a couple of activities. So thank you for having me. I appreciate all that you do on behalf of Colorado staff and students. I have a couple of action items. First one is classified appointment. Jackie Higgins is classified substitute, retired in January 20th.
Can I get a motion, please?
So moved.
First by Mrs. Miller.
Second.
Second by Mr. Jewell. Can I get a roll call, please?
Mrs. Miller?
Yes.
Mr. Jewell?
Yes.
Mrs. Langhart?
Yes.
Mrs. McIntosh?
Yes.
And Mrs. Miller?
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Bell. At this time, do we have any information for the legislative report? Oh, that's my section still. I was just reading along. Actually, I don't have anything other than what Dan was talking about earlier today. I'm sure that people are going to hear things. As people get back in session, they will all look forward to hopefully some positive changes for education. Mrs. Leifert, might we go to CTC?
Yes, CTC met on January 12, 2021 in regular session. And some were present and some were on Zoom, and I chose to be on the Zoom. So that's all I have.
Thank you. Do we have any old business that you can discuss? Any new business?
Talking about the vaccine that we're working with through here, we're going to do the last few of our staff members. I understand getting into the vaccine as soon as possible. the supervisor got booked up.
At this time, we're going to enter executive session for the employment, dismissal, discipline, promotion, demotion, or compensation of public employees, superintendent's contract. Can I get a motion, please? First by Mrs. Lightheart. Second by Mr. Jewell. Roll call, please.